don't have a lot of fun here, but once in a while, I'm an idea today.
Well, you hate fun as a rule.
In general, I hate fun.
Yeah, and when we try to have fun, normally it gets ruined in
some
way.
Doesn't work very well.
And what you hate fun, and I think what you hate more than fun is other people having fun.
That's the worst thing. I can't stand other people having fun. Yesterday, we were talking about Christmas movies, and we were talking about Home Alone, and there's some more of that today, you know.
Weather Dave, surprisingly knowledgeable.
On Home Alone.
On Home Alone.
I mean, he knew details that, I mean, I've seen the movie maybe 3-4 times.
He knows it. He was all in on Home Alone.
I had this thought later, okay?
Yeah.
Home Alone came out when I was a kid, and I loved it.
I love it, yeah.
Yeah.
So I think my age range loves that movie, which is also Dave's dating age range.
There it is.
Which is why I think
you're right.
He knows so much that at holiday time,
yes,
he's normally dating someone around my age group. And what do? Oh, Home Alone's our favorite. Can we watch Home Alone? Absolutely.
Yeah, right.
He knows it. Like he knows the he knows it inside and out.
Yeah, because his kids are too young for it.
Yeah,
but.
Yeah.
It lines up right with the age he dates.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe that's why he knows it so.
Because he was dropping dialogue and scenes and plot points and orders of things.
Because every year he hears, do you mind if we watch Home Alone?
All right. Let's watch Home Alone.
Sure. Whatever.
So he sees it every year.
Yeah.
Well, in that, here's how I hate fun. I like regimented, in your lane, do this at this time. This is what, it's a scheduled process. And at the end of it, the birth is given and that's it. You know what I'm saying? Like this show, we birth it every day. That's it. All right. Everything's compartmentalized. So they were talking about Christmas movies they like and Elf. Dave said the classics now, the new classics are Elf, Home Alone, and going as far back as A Christmas Story. And I agreed. And I was laughing alone. And then somebody brought up Bad Santa, which I hate.
Mm-hmm. I know that's your hot button.
And Chris, Demm, and Dave are like, oh, Bad Santa.
Yeah, my 16-year-old nephew loves it.
I hate it.
Yeah, I love it too, but I know you hate it.
Awful. It's awful. And I mean, it's vile. It's repulsive. I hate it. So when they got joy out of it, that just put me in a bad mood for the rest of the day. Mm-hmm. As soon as people start to have fun with things, especially that I don't like, turned off of it.
You hate that movie so much that when we got the chance to interview Billy Bob Thornton, you refused to bring up Bad Santa.
I would not bring up that.
You only let Chris Demm bring up, what is it?
Sling Blade.
I like Sling Blade. I like Sling Blade a lot. I hate Bad Santa. And so when it came up, it instantly ruined my joy. I can't have people having fun when I don't like whatever they're having fun. Yes, if somebody else is having fun and I see it, I can't stand it.
So someone is listening to a song. Say Biggie and I are enjoying a musical selection.
Mm-hmm.
You don't like the song. You don't even like us listening to it, getting pleasure from it.
No, that's right. Usually I try to point out how wrong it is that you like it.
Does that
like
make
it.
You a psychopath or a sociopath?
I think that's more socio.
I'll own it. I'll take it.
Because you don't become violent over it.
Not yet.
It's not inborn. To me, psycho means it's inborn. Socio means it's sort of. I'm always unclear on those.
Maybe
it's tricky.
It's one of. I walk a fine line in here, and I do want to explode in violence sometimes. But I'm
believe me, I've called you both under my breath.
But are you using it properly? See that
psychopath.
Well, here's today's fun, and I said we're going to do this today. I keep saying we're going to play the Hanukkah song. Because we're in the middle of Hanukkah and I haven't played it yet. And so we have an idea today. Later, we'll get somebody under 25 years old and I'll read out every celebrity in the Hanukkah song. There's about 20 of them that he mentions. Adam Sandler goes through and see how many the 22-year-old knows. And they have to, I'll say David Lee Roth, who is he? And they'll have to say who it is.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's going to be fun.
I love that.
Okay.
I think that's great.
Okay, let's see if we can have some fun with it today. Now that we'll do, and it's also right together with that, we have a Throwback Thursday game of Put Up or Shut Up Rock and Roll Trivia. And I just realized that today's Put Up or Shut Up game, and you know, we throw back on Thursday to a particular date on the Hot 100 chart,
top 10 were.
Yeah. And I like those. I think those are fun. And I just happened to notice today, Biggie said this is what we call a wheelhouse game for Kristen. This is in the middle of his his musical knowledge of this era is very, very strong. So you have to be a really good player to beat him today, for sure. He's going to do very well today. And I just happened to notice as I was going over my notes for this program that I think the date for the Put Up or Shut Up game is the day one of my good friends was born. And I said that to Chris. And I said, I think today's Put Up or Shut Up date is the day, and he knows him, my friend Ben was born. And Chris Demm said,
well, that's weird.
So what?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
So.
You know him, though, with birthdays.
He don't like a birthday. And I'm always confused. I know Ben, it's a September. I know he was born sometime in September, but I'm not sure if it's the exact date. So I just texted him about 10 minutes ago, and I said, listen, I think today's Put Up or Shut Up game is the day you were born, and I wrote down the date.
Well, I sure hope his reply was, this is inappropriate.
Yeah, it sounds like you're fishing for information to steal his identity. Hey, you know, I always have trouble with your birthday. What was it again? What day?
I lost some contacts in my phone. Yeah. I'm updating my calendar.
I think.
It definitely sounds like you're trying to steal his identity.
Well, plus I did it in the wee hours of the morning. I mean, I did this before 6 a.m.
I don't know if you know this or not, but what would you say your mother's maiden name is?
That street you grew up on, was it Elm or Elmwood?
Your dad have the same middle name?
I know his dog's name. His dog's name was Yoda when he was a kid. I know that because he's a huge Star Wars fan.
Ah.
And his dog's, and he's of that era, and his dog's name is Yoda. So I just said, hey, man, I think we got a birthday game for you. And so I wanted to make sure he tunes in and listens, which I'm sure he's going to reply, A, this is inappropriate, and B, what do I care?
I don't listen to your show.
I don't care.
We've had a number of interactions over the years. He's never brought up
the, No.
He's never brought up the program.
No, he's never gonna. He's like our friend Phil, who listened for the first couple of years and then finally now makes no bones about it. I don't listen
to
him here anymore. We were tight, dude. We were really good friends.
We were the Iron Four.
The Iron Four. We used to play Trivial Pursuit on Saturday nights.
That's right. That's right.
The Diesel, me, Chris Demm, and Phil. And Phil, after a few years, just went away from it. He's like, I don't. I'm not. For a while, he's kind of like, oh, yeah, the rock and roll game. And then he never really, and we knew he wasn't really listening. And then finally he said, yeah, I don't.
I like that none of them ever cared what you two did for a living.
Not at all.
I got to get up early. For what? the radio show we do. Oh, that's right. You guys do that cute little show.
You're still doing that? My God. You're still doing that?
Yeah.
You know, the other day, this is a put up or shut up factoid as well, the rock and roll trivia game. I mentioned this the other day. I came in while we were off on vacation to do some recording, and I noticed the Put Up or Shut Up rock and roll trivia game that was scheduled to run. It was like a best of, and it was scheduled to run. It was only half the length it should have been.
Oh, yeah.
So I just happened to see it, and the person who normally would be sitting here would not have known that. So I saw, that looks really short. So I listened to it, and we had what we call a corrupt file, and really, the whole thing was only 5 seconds. It was this.
Put up or shut up. Ed is on the line to try and take.
Ed. You know, when my voice is altered, it really shows what a poor broadcaster I am.
Ed.
He's on the line.
Yeah, like you do. Yeah, you're
it's horrible.
What's the word? Your technique is sort of magnified.
It's awful. Yeah, when you magnify it, yeah, you don't really hear it.
It stands out more.
Of course.
Put up or shut up. Ed is on the line to try and take.
Ed.
Huh?
Ed is on the line.
It's like, and when I'm in slow motion, there was one time it got too slow.
Yeah.
And I commented on Rob Lowe and said, he's hilarious.
Awful. Absolutely awful.
So, yeah, you hear.
Yeah.
You really.
Even at normal speed, you're barely tolerable.
Exactly. Well, look at Phil and Ben. Yeah. They don't care. They can't take it. I remember Phil's comment was when I challenged him on it after he had listened for a few years, then stopped, and I knew he stopped. I said, well, what is it? And he said, well, you're a lot to take to me.
On the radio? Period. On the radio.
He said,
off the radio.
He said, you tend to ramble, especially when you're nervous, and you're always nervous.
Wow. This man has known you a long time.
Oh, yeah. I've known him forever. And he said that to me.
And he's hilarious.
Put up or shut up. Ed is on the line to try and take.
That's all that was left. That's what would have aired. I changed it out. I caught it.
That was a save.
That was a save. I mean, it's a last second who just happened to be in the room, you know, and saved it.
I mean, if we awarded gold stars, you'd get one.
I would. And I needed one that was about the same length of the one that was scheduled to air. And I found I had to go back into our archives, and I grabbed one from 2015. And I don't know. I just plugged it into the system.
Wow.
I didn't hear it. I left. I joined the mass of non-listeners like Ben and Phil, and I did not.
You didn't want to hear it.
I didn't stick around, but
we didn't say complimentary things about people like Kevin Spacey or anything like that, did we?
God, oh my!
Have you seen House of Cards? That man can do no wrong.
Man, this Harvey Weinstein's going places. You know, one of those.
Just hit after hit with this guy.
Yeah, you got to be careful doing that.
Oh, you're so right. You're so right. Yeah. Lord knows what I said. You know, I have no idea how it came out like that. But anyway, today we have a Throwback Thursday, Put Up or Shut Up Rock and Roll Trivia.
Plus the Hanukkah bonus.
The Hanukkah bonus, I think, is going to be really fun.
I'm worried.
You are?
Because this is how the fun could get ruined, and I'll watch you. It'll drive you up a wall. We'll get a 25-year-old on.
Yep.
But you'll be like, who's so-and-so? And they'll be like, oh, no, bro.
Yeah.
They won't even guess.
See, what I think I was kind of coming to the same conclusion I think that Biggie is that you're leaving the fun up to the unknown.
The unknown.
Yeah.
You just don't know who you're going to get on the line. And I was looking through the people, and I thought, God, would people know who they are?
Well, now, wait a minute. Our friend Young Megan is downstairs.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
We know just have her. Megan She's play. Verified.
She could play.
Megan should play.
She should just come in here and play.
And she has a great personality, so we know we're not going to get the...
She does. Maybe we should just bring her up.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Maybe we should just bring her up. And how old is Megan, would you say? 20...
I would think 24, 25.
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay, I don't know.
Let me... Megan!
See how old she is.
Megan, how old are you?
See how old she is. And I like her.
Oh, yeah, she's delightful.
I like her. So she can come in here. I don't like people coming in.
No.
You know that. But I like her.
Yeah, and it avoids us getting somebody who on the phone who's just going to,
I don't know, bro. I don't know. I wasn't born, bro. But, you know, I considered B.B. Shea. And he's not here today. But I can say, because he's about 27. I thought maybe he could answer these. But he's really into pop culture and the history of, you know, I think he would know a lot of these celebrities. You just want an average 20-something to see, would you know?
Well, and B.B. Shea's above that age. I think he's
27 or he's 29, 27.
Yeah,
So, but I thought he's got pretty good knowledge of stuff because he likes to go back and look at like old movies and things like that. Now, and for speaking of young and old, Chris Demm just had, what's her how old?
Megan's 26, so she's right in her age.
All right, let's listen to that. Okay. But do you think she knows too much? Would it be an accurate representation? She's smart.
She's in the media.
She's on the ball.
Yeah.
You know, she really is.
And plus, who would run the cameras?
Right. What would we do? If she's not there to run
cameras.
If
she's not there to run them. I mean,
what could we do? Might not be able to have Megan in here. I think she's too bright. I think she's too.
That's possible. Yeah.
I do. I think she's too. We want a representation of somebody just average.
Not a dullard.
No.
It's going to be Biggie's going to
have an average.
The right person. He's going to have to
get
the right
person. Well, we'll see. I'll look for somebody who, when I say two guys named Chris, they go, huh?
Right. Okay. That's what we.
Hello, two guys named Chris.
Could get my son. He's
wake him up. Yeah.
He's 16.
Oh, you'll get him in trouble texting at school again.
Well, he doesn't, you know, he has that weird schedule. He could do this at the time.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, because he doesn't have to be there until later than most.
I feel like he's too young. I feel like 25 is a perfect age range for this because it'll be people you have heard of, but you might not exactly know why.
Well, and the song is 25 years old. He did the song 25 years ago, just like the anniversary of it.
Well, and I mean, look, I've heard that song a ton of times, and there's people
you don't
I've
know?
Heard that I didn't know.
Do you know them now?
There's probably still a few that I'd be like, I don't know.
The late Dinosaur?
No.
You don't know who Dinosaur is?
Yeah.
My son has never heard that.
No.
I know. There's no way. Now, speaking of old and young, Chris Demm just witnessed something. I dropped my pen a moment ago.
This is the moment right before we push ourselves away from our desks and our computers and make a long walk down the hall.
I was up late pickling last night. An impromptu pickleball game. I don't want to... This is really, talk about a slap in the face to my regular guys. I mean, I really, there's some guys I play with on Tuesday nights I love.
Yeah.
We play.
These are the guys we think that you're considering inviting to your Super Bowl.
That's right. They're great guys. I think they're great. But my friend the Diesel and I, we're playing in a tournament on Saturday. And my wife only lets me play one night a week. So Diesel said, I'll tell you what, instead of playing Tuesday...
With the usual crew,
let's play Wednesday and I'll try to up the competition, the talent level a little bit.
So he's out there beating the bushes looking for
better
players. Super talent.
He wanted people that would really push us going into, you know, play up going into the weekend. And I said, okay. So I skipped Tuesday to play with.
You were playing later against tougher competition.
And it was tougher competition for sure. Yeah. Higher level talent.
So your pen hits the ground.
Oh, so I'm sore today. And my pen, I dropped my pen off the desk. And I said to Chris Demm, well, I can't do the show.
That's it.
And I can't bend over.
I said, is there nothing else in your desk drawer that can bend halfway over and retrieve?
No, there was no other. And I had to get down. I basically had to lay on the floor instead of actually bending.
Sneak up on it.
Oh, Chris Demm had to watch it. The sounds of me bending.
The creaking.
I might need an emergency session with Landon.
Moaning, yeah.
I might have to go to Landon over at Stretch Zone and get an emergency stretch in here today.
Well, you know what? You should probably do it.
Yes.
A, he'd be happy to see you. And B, you can give him his Christmas tip.
Wait a minute now. Landon and I
have a relationship.
Well, we have an understanding.
It's been months.
No money will change hands. That's it. Landon and I up front. We both agree.
You don't want to sully what you have?
No. This is about friendship.
Ah, yes. For you, it's the most avoided time of the year.
Yes, it is.
For you, avoid everyone.
Yes, it is.